So I don't think there are really only finger vibrato or wrist vibrato or arm vibrato. You can have the most effective practice skills ever. This video will improve your tone production, relaxation, vibrato, technical skills, and even help you play more musically. Playing is not practicing.
What?
It means if you want to improve your violin playing, it will not help you to play the violin constantly as you practice every day. We acquire skills in one way when we get comprehensible input in a low anxiety environment. The low anxiety environment, which means you know you're in control of the playing by knowing how your body muscles work. That's why we practice slowly. Hello, I'm Jinny. Today's video is about how to practice consciously. If you practice slowly, thinking about why you didn't like the sound you make, why fingers are not the way they should be, which muscles are not properly working, you'll save so much time and improve every day. I'm going to talk about body muscle roles, and this is what we already know. But if we relate this to violin playing, I can assure you that you can have the most effective practice skills ever. So please do not skip this. What I'm going to say in this video will improve your tone production, relaxation, vibrato, technical skills, and even help you play more musically. There are about 600 muscles in the human body. We should make natural sounds by using many muscles. In order to do that, we have to hold the violin and the bow with natural angles where body muscles can be easily and naturally used. There are some major muscles you need to know in order to play the violin. The abdominal muscles support the trunk and allow body movement. The trapezius muscles help support the weight of the arm and move the shoulder. The pectoralis major is a thick, fan-shaped muscle situated at the chest of the human body. Its functions are flexion, adduction, and internal rotation of the upper arm. The deltoid is the prime mover of the arm. The bicep is a large muscle that lies on the front of the upper arm between the shoulder and the elbow. Its main function is to flex and twist forearm. The latissimus dorsi is the largest muscle in the upper body. It's responsible for the extension, adduction, and rotation of the shoulder. Finger extension muscles on the forearm extend the hand and fingers. Then, how should the left and the right fingers be placed to use those major muscles to make sounds you want? First of all, fingers do not contain muscles. The muscles that move the finger joints are in the palm and forearm. Please think about the major muscles I just mentioned earlier. Find the body core and use the left upper arm to support the violin. To use the upper arm muscle, your chest, back and shoulder muscles should be balanced out. Place the violin neck between your thumb and the index finger, then move your upper arm around. Those fingers touching the violin's neck should be the axis of the left arm's movement. So make sure this touching feeling is always soft to be free of your fingers' movement. Let's talk about the left hand. The feeling should be like clenching a fist softly. The fingers can be slightly leaned towards the violin scroll. Not like this. They should be slightly leaned towards the violin scroll. Where does the thumb go? You can see the muscles under the first joint of the thumb. Your rest of the four fingers will be supported by this muscle. So do not think about the tip of your finger, because what you have to think about is this muscle. This muscle should be free. So sometimes you'll be holding like this, sometimes like this. So it all depends on where your fingers are and which position you are on. And the thumb is supported by the forearm, which is also supported by the upper arm. Are you following me? And the upper arm is supported by lots of upper body muscles. That's why good posture is very, very important. So practicing without a bow is one of many practical ways to practice. Make sure this is free. Vibrato. The logic applies to your vibrato as well. The movement of your finger joints when you do vibrato should be starting from right angles of your fingers. Thumb muscle supporting fingers. Arm muscle supporting the hand muscles. Upper body muscles supporting the entire of your arm and the hand. So I'm talking about the same thing again, right? I'm sure you have heard of finger vibrato, wrist vibrato, and arm vibrato. Subjectively, I think it's hard to separate clearly. Moving fingers, even knees muscle support on your arm. So I can't do vibrato without using my upper arm at all. Even though I'm using just narrow vibrato with this, with the finger, I still feel that this is moving. So I don't think there are really only finger vibrato or wrist vibrato or arm vibrato. It's just my opinion. So I'd rather look for vibrato style getting along with the music and phrasing than deciding between finger, wrist, or arm vibrato. I'll talk more about vibrato in another video later. Shifting. Let the upper arm, which is the strongest and the biggest muscle in the arms, help the forearm and the hand movement. So if you think, oh, I have to shift, I'm gonna use my finger to move, that's already late. So you have to think you are going to move your finger from here, the big muscles. Because fingers do not contain muscles, always from the big muscles. If I practice, like, you can focus on my upper arm. It's already awkward. But if you think your upper arm is constantly moving, that'll be less awkward. I'll talk about shifting, like how to find the right intonation, in a future video later. Let's talk about bow technique. Drawing can be compared to playing the violin. The majority of left-hand techniques can be drawing tools, and the bow can be drawing brushes. The white sketchbook can be the pure and natural sound the violin has. Then, sketching and applying colors can be the bowing technique and making music. Pure natural sound. The pure natural sound means the resonant sound naturally coming out of the violin with the minimum effort. When you can make the natural resonant sound, you can make various colorful sounds you want. Fingers should be naturally falling down the bow from the bass knuckles. Grab the bow with the minimum effort of the palm muscles because the fingers do not have muscles. So you are going to use the palm muscles and natural fingers angle to grab the bow. If you are trying to hold the bow unnaturally, it's already wrong because you are going to make squeaky sound and unnatural sound. The upper arm muscles help the palm muscles to hold the bow lightly. So make sure your upper arm is not too low or not too high. Just natural level to be able to hold the bow naturally. Upper body muscles also help the upper arm to be able to feel gravity and naturally sit on the bow. Naturally sit on the bow. The upper body muscle. I keep repeating, I know. This is very important. For the down bow, you should feel leaning into the index finger. At the same time, the muscles below the pinky get lighter, like riding a seesaw. If you are not sure about the leaning into the index finger feeling, you can try this. You can try to hold the bow with the only index finger and press it with your upper arm, and those three fingers will be just naturally hanging there. Then slightly just place it. Do not try to grab it, just place it. Then you'll feel leaning feeling. So you're pressing the bow from the upper arm, actually from the upper part of your body, right? For the up bow, you still lean into the index finger though. The other part of the palm muscles help the pinky to support the bow weight because the bow gets heavier. This is frog and this part gets heavier when you go lower part of the bow. So you keep leaning, but help those fingers to feel the balance, seesaw. Sounds dynamic. Each string has a different thickness. You should be able to control the pressure of the bow because the tension depends on where your left fingers on the string and where the bow locates. You always have to listen carefully to the sound you make for sounds you want to make. Let's say the pure natural sounds dynamic is mezzo piano or mezzo forte. For piano, pianissimo or pianissimo, your bow pressure gets lighter, further from the bridge, and the bow speed gets a little bit faster. For forte, fortissimo, fortissimo, your bow pressure gets heavier, closer to the bridge, and the bow speed gets a little bit slower. If I try to do same bow speed, that's not gonna work, see? So I have to slow down a little bit. Using vibrato makes the sound even colorful. The vibrato always from here, right? Upper part. Seeing a big picture, phrasing. Why do you hear a music piece differently from different players? It's hard to understand if someone keeps stopping while he's talking. It is hard to understand if I speak like this. It's hard to appreciate the music if phrasing keeps breaking.
Nope.
If we compare to reading a book, how we make voice, pronunciation, breathing can decide the fluency. The fluency in music can be made with good intonation, rhythm, color of each note, how to make connections between notes, and where the connections end. Thank you. practice is thinking about everything at the same time. Like you're comfortable enough to fix technical issues while you express your music. As a teacher, I try to communicate with my students about what kind of musical ideas they have. Then if they have ideas and if they cannot quite show it yet, it's my job to figure out what kind of technical difficulties they are going through. When they understand that, they can practice much more easily. So if you become your own teacher, observe yourself consciously and continuously, you can always have effective practice time. Thanks for watching. If it was helpful, please press the like button. Also, if you have any questions and requests, please leave a comment below. I'll see you in the next video.